Good morning. The title of the presentation is Integrated Methodologies for Knowledge and Valorization of Roman Casinum City. The coordinator of research is the Professor Michela Cigola, who is here, and Professor Gallozzi, Arturo, Leonardo Paris, and Emanuela Chiavoni. Focus of this article is the documentation, interpretation, valorization and communication of archaeological heritage of Roman Casinum City site. Nowadays, this important archaeological area is little known and appreciated. We are only at the very first steps of our research. The research group is formed by University of Cassino, Laboratory of Documentation, Analysis, Survey of Architecture and Territory of University of Cassino, by Laboratory of Architectural Survey, Kritevat Center in City Rieti, by Department of History, Drawing and Restoration of Architecture, Sapienza University of Rome, and by l'area Laboratory of Survey and Architecture Engineering, Area University of Rome, Tor Vergata. The Cassino, also the structure like the Cassino National Archaeological Museum, G. Carrettoni, and the Archaeological Park of Cassino, are involved and collaborated in the research. A little history. Cassino is a modern town since it has been completely rebuilt after the destruction during the Second World War, and it is quite famous for the Monte Cassino Abbey. Cassino is located just below the mountain where the Cassino Abbey is situated. The history of the city of Cassino and the Benedictine monastery of Monte Cassino are very closely linked. The city appears to be historically consolidated up to the Second World War, when any trace of the East Pass was lost. Monte Cassino, the famous abbey, and Cassino City. During the Second World War, a line crossed the main route north to Rome. It was very close to Cassino and Monte Cassino Abbey. A strong battle was waged there, known of the Battle of Monte Cassino. Many soldiers were killed, both the Germans and the Allied. In 1940, to break the Gustav Line and to reach Roma, the Allied decided bombing the Abbey, sfortunately, that was completely destroyed in 15 February. In 1944. A month after, the Allied decided bombing the city of Cassino that was also destroyed on 15 March, always 1944. We can see the ruins of Cassino City. Cassino has an archaeological area. There are two different areas. In red, you can see Roman city area and medieval city area. Here, we rotated the map to orient it in the same way of ancient maps. Here, the same areas in an engraved representation of land of San Benedictis. Terra Santi Benedicti, famous Santi Benedicti. Territory governed by the abbey from 80 to 50 century. Always the representation of the city. The Roman city of Cassinum, this was the Roman name of Cassino, is particularly flourishing in Republican of Imperial Roman period. From this period are the remains of the Roman Via Latina, the theater, about the first century BC. The amphitheater, the Nymphaeum, and the tomb of Umidia Quadratilla, the names, always 1st century BC. Roman Casinum had two plans in Republican period and in August Imperial period. The Republican plan has an axe, Via Latina Nova, that today is the road to Monte Cassino Abbey. The second plan was made by a grid that have to accord with a non-regular orography. We can see the plan. The medieval city was born on the ancient axis of the Roman city, but in an unhigher area for defensive motives. It's very interesting that these two axes are today the most important of Cassino because are the axes from Rome and Naples. The archaeological area survey. Our research includes several integrated methodologies. The main part involves a laser scanner survey of the whole area. There are many other steps that include digital processing about documentation, interpretation, and communication of Casinum archaeological area. You can see orthographic views of point cloud from amphitheater and Numidia Quadratilla tomb. The main part involves laser scanners, survey of the whole area. Here the theater, you can see, always point cloud view theater, 1st century BC. And the other, here the Umidia Quadratilla tomb, always you can see point cloud view. And also the other part, the Nymphaeum, particularly Nymphaeum, you can see point cloud view. Other study is direct analysis watercolor. Is a particular analysis that here there is the objective of the study was to integrate the analytical data coming from the laser scanner survey of a complex monument like the Casinum archaeological area with a more traditional and direct analysis performed through watercolor drawings from life by superimposing them on the results of the laser scanner survey. This integration resulted in a more useful and complete scientific representation, enabling us to identify and communicate the essence of the monument itself, since the information about its form. Geometry and proportions were combined with immaterial aspects such as the color and the effect. For us, it's very important this analysis to understand very well directly in the place the intangible and immaterial aspects like the light, the different light in all part of the day, and also the atmosphere, and also the other aspects like the materials or the pictures or the conservation of the materials on the place. Watercolor drawings of Nymphaeum, you can see, because always in our research, freehand drawing establishes direct contact between the built object and the person who draws. We occupy of drawing and we can see water drawings of Nymphaeum. Another drawing with pencil and traditional drawing with pencil and with watercolor with the objective retracing history through drawing and to analyze the color and the retracing history through the drawing. This is the amphitheatrum. And in the end, to search also harmony of forms and color, certainly subjective experience and objective knowledge as approaches to drawing. Thanks for attention. I want only to add that the integration, methodology integration, traditional and also technological analysis are very important to know the cultural heritage and in this case archaeological heritage. Thank you.
Thank you.